When we first broke the story Friday, now the mother of a former Nottoway Valley High School wrestler is talking exclusively to News Channel 8 about the alleged hazing and sexual assault. Laura Nichols is just back from Greenfield with her story. Laura.
Stacy, this mother wanted to speak out, but just before she was about to talk with us on camera, she says she received anonymous phone calls from people who threatened to hurt her and her son if she talked with us. So she asked that we not identify her, and we want to warn you, the details of this story are disturbing.
Talked to several parents, several other people in the community, and it's sad because they do know what's going on, but they don't want to stand up.
This woman says she couldn't remain quiet much longer after hearing disturbing details from her son about what he says went on in the locker room at Nottoway Valley High School. She says her son watched in horror as several members of the wrestling team sexually assaulted another teammate as a punishment for missing practice.
Coaches told the captains, you do what you want, you know, with the punishment. The coaches left the room. It all happened. Three of them were mainly holding them down. The one stuck the jump rope up his bottom, his rear end.
Greenfield police say the incident happened in late December and involved several students, but won't reveal anything else. So far, a former wrestler, a Greenfield resident, and now this mother have all come forward to talk about it, but only if they remain anonymous. This woman says right before she was about to speak with us on camera, she received threatening phone calls from voices she said sounded like teenage boys.
They just said, we know who you are, we know where you live. Don't think we won't come after you.
Her son recently quit the team, but she says she's afraid that if she doesn't speak out, another student will get sexually assaulted.
I think small towns is point blank. They don't want to get involved. They want to cover it up. They don't want anybody to believe that things like this can happen in their community. And that's why they're not willing to stand up for what's right.
Superintendent Casey Burlaw told us over the phone today that the school has identified the students that were involved and is taking disciplinary actions. However, he would not elaborate on any of those details.
Very interesting developments. Laura, thank you.